spang the Baptist cry announces that the Lord is night. Awaken, hearken, for he brings glad tidings of the King of Kings. Then cleanse be every soul from sin, make straight the way of God within. Prepare we in our hearts a home where such a mighty guest may come. For thou art our salvation, Lord, our refuge and our sure reward. Shine forth and let thy light restore our souls to heavenly grace once more. All praise, eternal Son, to thee, whose advent set thy people free, whom with the Father we adore, and Holy Spirit evermore.
Today we continue our Advent tradition. We light two Advent candles with the light of peace burning bright. Faithfully, we wait for his coming. Faithfully, it shines through the night. In our humble heart, a fire burns as well. Hear the prayers these flames would tell.
The Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
My friends, as we continue our celebration this Advent season with the second Sunday of Advent, let us prepare our hearts, prepare our minds to celebrate these sacred mysteries and to make room for Christ in our lives. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, and in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at an end. Her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out, "In the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain, the rough country a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom and leading the ewes with care." The word of the Lord.
Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaimed peace to his people. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. Kindness and truth shall meet, justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him and prepare the way of his steps. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord, one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years like one day. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some regard delay, but he is patient with you, not wishing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a mighty roar, and the elements will be dissolved by fire, and the earth and everything done on it will be found out. Since everything is to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be, conducting yourselves in holiness and devotion, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in flames and the elements melted by fire. But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him, at peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his path. All flesh shall see the salvation of God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way. A voice of one crying out in the desert, 'Prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight his paths.'" John the Baptist appeared in the desert, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. People of the whole Judean countryside and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem were going out to see him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River as they acknowledged their sin. John was clothed in camel hair with a leather belt around his waist. He fed on locusts and wild honey. And this is what he proclaimed: "One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When we had our first cold day about 3 weeks ago, I went and grabbed my long black coat out of my storage closet. And I looked over in the corner, and I realized there's 5 cardboard boxes stacked there in the corner. And I was wondering, what is in those boxes? So I decided I was going to pull off the top one, took it out of the closet, opened it up, and lo and behold, it was all my papers from seminary. And I realized I didn't get really the grades I wanted in seminary. But I also realized why I forgot about those boxes, because I just wanted seminary to be shoved in the corner and I'll deal with it later. Maybe I'll keep the things, maybe I won't, maybe it'll be helpful. But now this is my 8th year of priesthood. And part of me is thinking, okay, do I keep it or not? I kept it. Because you don't know. Maybe next week I'll have some great insight that will require me to go to those 4 boxes and to see some paper I wrote 12 years ago. You don't know. And I say all this because I think we all go through this process of, what are we holding on to? What are we truly keeping in our lives that maybe in some senses we will need? But there's a lot of things we're holding on to in our lives that we don't need. And yes, I talk specifically about things, but there's lots of things in our lives as well that don't have a physical place. We have feelings we hold on to. And many of those feelings are not helpful. We have memories we hold on to that are not helpful. We have failed relationships that we hold on to that are not helpful. And we hold on to these realities because I think in some senses we believe that by holding on to them, they could help us. Maybe they could redirect us. Maybe it could lead to some great insight later in our lives. But we have to be careful. Because when we prepare the way of the Lord in our lives, when we really look at ourselves honestly and heed John the Baptist's call that we hear in the gospel today, I don't think we're adding much if we're going to be truthful. A lot of what we have to do to accomplish the conversion process in our lives is to let go of things. At least that's true in my life at 39. And I imagine a few of you who've had a few more sunsets in your life probably could say the same. What do I have to actually let go of so that I can experience the fullness that God wants to give me through His Son, Jesus Christ, by the power of the Spirit? And I think the second reading this weekend also confirms this reality of having to let go. Because Peter reminds us, since everything is going to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be? Conducting yourselves in holiness and devotion, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God. Notice he doesn't say be busy worrying about the past or storing up things in the future or trying to resolve every problem. It's all going to dissolve away. And maybe in some senses that's not helpful in light of the pandemic, because other things have gone out of our lives, and maybe in some senses letting go actually makes us a little bit worse in this season of our lives. But I do think it is a big challenge. What can we let go of so that our hearts and our minds can be more open to Jesus' call? And let me also just challenge us as well that by letting go, we are healed. And I know sometimes, again, it does not feel that way when we actually let go of memories and feelings or even giving away things. But it always, I think, will lead us to a greater consolation and peace once we do let those things go. And the prophet Isaiah, in our first reading, also gave some great insight, not only about John the Baptist, but I also think gave some great insight into what conversion means in our lives. When the valleys are filled in, when the mountains are made low, when the rugged land is made plain, that is when the glory is revealed. That is when God and His grace is most apparent. So in some senses, we have to experience the conversion, we have to let go in order to experience the glory, the grace, and the joy that only God can give us if we're willing to go through that process. So during this Advent season, maybe we can clean out some closets. But I think more importantly, we need to clean out our hearts, clean out our minds, allow the Lord to meet us in those places so that we can experience the healing and peace that He wants to give through His Son, Jesus Christ. And if we can do that during this Advent season, this Christmas, in many ways, even though it'll be very different than what we've experienced in the past, can truly be a joyful time where we have prepared for the birth of Christ in such a special way that it'll forever change our lives. Together now, let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a life for the world to come. Amen. Always seeking the consolation of our Heavenly Father, we now present these our needs before Him and place our trust in His loving response.
For Pope Francis and all church leaders, may the Lord continue to bless them with fortitude and growth in holiness. We pray to the Lord. For world leaders, may the Holy Spirit give them the graces necessary for governing with prudence, justice, fortitude, and temperance. We pray to the Lord. For those oppressed by any evil in the world, may Christ bring justice and healing to their circumstances. We pray to the Lord. For the whole world, may the Lord look upon us in His mercy and bring an end to the sickness and divisiveness brought about by COVID-19. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each of us, may the Holy Spirit continue to prepare our hearts for the coming of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions for the benefactors of this Mass, we pray to the Lord. For all the faithful departed, all the intentions listed in our book of prayers, and for all of our own intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, you gather us in and shepherd us with care. Please hear the prayers we have offered today, for we make them all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Ready to wait. Make straight the road, raise the valleys and mountains make low. Turning from sin, let the broken be whole, and ready the way of the Lord. Ready the way, ready the way. Ready the way of the Lord. Ready the way, ready the way, ready the way of the Lord. As we wait for you, give us the strength to walk in your truth, so we may love more like you, and ready the way for you, Lord. Ready the way, ready the way, ready the way of the Lord. Ready the way of the Lord. Let us see your face in our hearts. We prepare a place. Come bring this word, your mercy and grace. As we ready the way for you, Lord. Ready the way, ready the way, ready the way of the Lord. Ready the way, ready the way, ready the way. The way of the Lord.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father, the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, Come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us a way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. In giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of his Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, who blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John Damascene and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
At this time, you can make your spiritual communion at home.
Those who were in the dark are thankful for the sunlight. We who live, we who die are grateful for his gift. Thankful for his love.
Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Here at Our Lady of Victory, we're still having confessions available during this Advent season. So the next two Sundays from 1 p.m. till 3 p.m., and then Thursday evenings from 5 to 7, in addition to our normal confession times on Saturday morning and Saturday evenings. Also, if people want to schedule a private appointment, please just call the parish office, and myself or Father Scott will make ourselves available to have your confession heard during this holy season. And finally, I hope everyone has a blessed week, and truly, if you need anything, let us know here at the parish. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Comfort, comfort, O my people, speak of peace, now says our God. Comfort those who sit in darkness, mourning need their sorrows, Lord. Speak unto Jerusalem of the peace that waits for them. Tell of all the sins I cover, and that warfare now is over. Hark the voice of one who's crying in the desert far and near, bidding all to full repentance, since the kingdom now is here. Oh, that warning cry obey, now prepare for God a way. Let the valleys rise to meet him, and the hills bow down to greet him. Oh, make straight what long was crooked, make the rougher places plain. Let your hearts be true and humble, as befits his holy reign. For the glory of the Lord, now all earth is shed abroad, and all flesh shall see the token that his word is never broken.
Good morning. I'm going to give you tips on how to keep your cognitive skills healthy. To do that, we need to know what good cognitive health is. It is the ability to clearly think, learn, and remember. It is an important part of performing everyday activities. What's good for your heart is good for your brain. The heart supplies the brain with the oxygen it needs to function. Therefore, schedule regular checkups with your health provider. Consult with your doctor about the medicines you take and possible side effects on memory, sleep, and brain functions. Manage chronic health problems like diabetes, high blood pressure, depression, obesity, and high cholesterol. Preventing or controlling high blood pressure not only helps your heart, but helps your brain too. Decades of trial studies have shown that having high blood pressure in midlife, the 40s to the mid-60s, increases the risk of cognitive decline later in life. Routine visits to your doctor's office will pick up changes in your blood pressure, even if you feel fine. Reduce risk for brain injuries due to falls and other accidents. Wear helmets and seat belts to help prevent head injuries as well. Don't smoke and limit your alcohol consumption. Some medicines can be dangerous when mixed with alcohol. Get enough sleep, generally 7 to 9 hours each night. At any age, getting a good night's sleep supports brain health. sleep problems, not getting enough sleep, sleeping poorly, and sleep disorders can lead to trouble with memory, concentration, and other cognitive functions. Eat a balanced diet. We need to exercise our brain to keep it in shape. Learning new skills may improve your thinking ability. For example, one study found that older adults who learned quilting, dance, or digital photography had more memory improvement than those who only socialized. Many activities can keep your mind active. For example, play brain games like crossword puzzles, Sudoku, and word searches. Take or teach a class. Pass on your knowledge. The recall process and teaching of an activity utilizes multiple parts of your brain. Some scientists have argued that such activities may protect the brain by establishing cognitive reserve. They may help the brain become more adaptable in some mental functions so it can compensate for age-related brain changes and health conditions that affect the brain. Do not let your brain fall into a routine. Challenge it on a daily basis. People who engage in meaningful and productive activities with others tend to live longer, boost their mood, and have a sense of purpose. Consider volunteering for a local organization. Even our church, Our Lady of Victory, has plenty of opportunities for serving. Check out programs and classes available through Milestones Area Agency on Aging. Their number is 563-324-9085, or the Center for Active Seniors, CASI. Their number is 563-386-7477. Stress is a natural part of life. Short-term stress can even focus our thoughts, but chronic stress can change the brain and affect memory. To help manage stress and build the ability to bounce back from stressful situations, here are several things you can do. Keep a calendar. This way you will be prepared and organized for the day's task, which will reduce your stress level. Write in a journal. Putting your thoughts or worries on paper can help you let go of an issue or see a new solution. Try relaxation techniques. Practices such as mindfulness, which involves focusing awareness on the present moment without judgment, or breathing exercises can help your body relax. These can help lower your blood pressure, lessen muscle tension, and reduce stress. Stay positive. Release grudges or things beyond your control. Practice gratitude, or pause to enjoy the simple things, like a comfort of a cup of tea, or the sunrise or sunset. By taking steps now to reduce your risk for cognitive decline, you'll help to maintain your good brain health for the future. Next week, Carol will introduce some physical activities to help keep your body healthy. Have a blessed week.
The lambs in his arms.
myself will shepherd them, for others have led them astray. The lost I will rescue and heal their wounds and pasture them, giving them rest. Like a shepherd he feeds his flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home. Come unto me if you are heavily burdened, and take my yoke upon your shoulders. I will give you rest. Like a shepherd he feeds his flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home, leading them home. Like a shepherd he feeds his flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home. Say to the cities of Judah, prepare the way of the Lord. Go to the mountain top, lift your voice, Jerusalem, here is your God. Like a shepherd he feeds his flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home. I myself will shepherd them, for others have led them astray. The lost I will rescue and heal their wounds and pasture them, giving them rest. Like a shepherd he feeds his flock